Kelly, three people are in the hospital tonight after another crossover accident on K-10, Johnson County. It happened on K-10 near Kill Creek Road in DeSoto, a portion of K-10 that does not have cables in the median. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney is live with the very latest. Michael?
Larry, as you know, some portions of K-10 Highway between Lenexa and Lawrence do have these crossover prevention cables, but they're not everywhere. And today, near DeSoto, that was part of the problem. News Chopper 9 shot this video of the accident scene just moments after the crash. The Highway Patrol says the driver of a pickup truck heading east tried to change lanes and didn't see the Elantra in the lane next to him. The Elantra tried to swerve, but they hit each other, and the Elantra went into the median. The pickup crossed over to the westbound lanes and was hit broadside by a third car. Rescue workers had to extricate three of the injured. All of this happened just a few hundred yards east of the Kill Creek Road overpass outside of DeSoto.
It's a long, straight, flat road. But the problem today, just like anywhere, is inattentive driving. We need to be paying more attention.
She runs Wanda's Roadside Cafe in DeSoto, where the accident was a topic all day long. Well, 2 years ago, a series of crossover accidents on K-10 led the highway department to install about 2.5 miles of median cables on parts of K-10. This portion of the highway, however, was not included in the crossover cable project.
The whole length of the road, too. Most people are for it. I don't think I've heard any against it.
I've seen way too many accidents along the stretch of highway.
A spokesman for KDOT says the effectiveness of these crossover cables along K-10 will be reviewed in a couple of years, but there's no push now to extend the cable network further along K-10. If three people are injured in a crossover accident, another one along K-10 Highway. Now, KDOT, the Kansas Highway Department, is thinking about widening K-10 over here in this part of Kansas City from 4 lanes now to 6. If they do that, and they are just considering it, but if they do that, then the cables will be replaced with concrete barriers. But again, they're just thinking about that. That's the latest. Back to you.
Michael Mahoney, thank you very much. We just checked on the conditions of the people injured in today's crossover crash. Juan Marino Lopez of Olathe is in critical condition. Carlos Torres Oliva is in stable condition. Bruce Martin of Baldwin City, the driver of the truck that crossed the median, is also in stable condition tonight.